don't understand why you can't you see that when you're dreaming, you're supposed to dream about me. Dream about me. Yeah.
How adorable, right? We were just saying, can you believe that's a year ago? It was a year ago. And then she was just 14 years old when she performed here for us last year on Fox 8. We're so excited to have Cleveland's own Isabella Moner back with us this morning for an update on her blossoming career and now tons of movies. So exciting to see you here. We said to you, please, when you get even more famous than you were a year ago, we said, please come back and see us. God bless her. She did. She didn't remember us little folks. So welcome.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me again. I'm just really glad to, you know, be at home. I'm actually going to fly out to LA right after this for a movie screening of Legends of the Hidden Temple.
Yeah, so tell us. Sorry. So this is a huge movie. It's a Nickelodeon movie. And so you have that coming up. And we're looking at some video of it right now.
Yeah, it's... I think that's the first trailer that came out.
Is this the first movie you did? Because last time we saw you, you were doing a TV series for Nickelodeon.
Yeah, no, this the first movie I did was Middle School, The Worst Years of My Life.
Okay.
And that's in theaters right now, actually. It came out October 7th.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm super psyched
and
about
now this is
yeah,
from
this
that, right?
is it. They got it.
That's you?
That's me with the glasses.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah, no one ever really recognized me right away, but yeah, that was really fun. We filmed that in Atlanta. I just can't wait to film a movie in Cleveland. That would be great.
And that'll happen because we're getting more and more movies here.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it's weird. The whole location thing is weird. It's really random.
Yeah.
But like for Transformers, we filmed in Arizona, Detroit, London. You know, those three places don't really, they're not very similar.
So Transformers, she just mentioned that, and that's so exciting. Well, what a huge movie to be part of.
How did you break into it?
Because you were living in Cleveland here on the West Side. Your brothers are here and in school, and this was something that you really wanted to pursue. Did you go out to LA, get an agent? How did it all happen for you?
It really happened quite fast, actually. I was doing musical theater here in Ohio, and then the director said that he really thought I could make it on Broadway, and that was kind of my first, you know, passion was to make it on Broadway, and so we went to New York. One thing happened after another. Basically, we went to New York. Vocal coach saw me. He thought I was amazing. Contacted managers and agents. They contacted me, and it just happened really fast. And then since then I had to work to, you know, get the show and then the movies and see there's 100 things to do before high school. That was my first TV show. I was the lead. I got to sing the theme song. It's been great. I've been very blessed. And thankfully, my mother has been here with me along the way.
You said she travels with you. You're still, 15 years old?
Yeah, and actually, my first magazine cover, my first newsstand.
Look at this.
It's on the newsstands today. It's Girls Life magazine. You can see it right there. It says Isabella Moner, Queen of 2017.
Wow. I mean, just have to feel like you're on the brink of something.
I mean, they were really nice to say that.
But this is fantastic, and you can get this in all the bookstores.
Everywhere. Yeah, you can just look for my face. It might be a little hard to miss.
When you come home, you get to see your friends,
yes,
and you're still just the same girl that grew up here.
I'm very thankful for my friends that I still have here. They keep me grounded, level-headed. So does my family. They said they'll slap me if I ever get a big head.
I know
I'm
that won't
thankful.
Happen because you have that core, that sweetness about you.
Oh, thank you.
Every time
thank
you've
you.
Been here, you're just adorable. So we know you're still writing music, you're still performing,
yes, yes.
And you've got a CD coming out.
I've got it's the last music video of my album Stopping Time, my first album. It's called Every Girl. And it's really about female empowerment and, you know, bringing up girls and saying, even though we are totally different, we should embrace our differences and, lift up each other, uplift each other. And it's called Every Girl, meaning like it describes every single other girl and that in the end, we all just want to be loved and we should all love each other.
So, such a positive message for young women,
and
especially.
And the music video, definitely, I think it does a good job of showing that. I involve a bunch of my friends from L.A. And actually, I had someone fly out from New York. She's a dancer. She's amazing. Mm-hmm. And I had her be in the music video. And everyone's dancing and everyone's dressed up as a different character. It's really great.
That's really great. Well, we're proud of you. You're doing wonderful things. And thank you for being still so sweet. And you'll come back next year and see us?
Yes. Thank you. Legends of the Hidden Temple, November 26th. Nickelodeon.
And look for her, a hometown girl gone amazing.
Thank you so much. I love you guys.
You're adorable. We love you.